If you would have asked me 10 years ago, would I be thinking about going across the world to share the gospel, to talk to middle school students and high school students about drugs and alcohol, to talk to them about how important it is for them to surrender their life to God, I would have said, you're crazy. There's absolutely no way I can do that. But yet, time after time, when I get out of my own way, God surprises me in the way that He utilizes me in my life and the opportunities that He puts in front of me to help others and to serve others. My name is Robert Lopez. I am one of the youth leaders here at Calvary Church. I'm also involved in mission trips to the Philippines, and where we partner with Pastor Gil Fernandez, in his work with school kids to share the gospel and talk about drugs and alcohol. Much like here in the States, they have distractions that pull them away from God. And there, drugs and alcohol are so prevalent, so strong, that it becomes an idol in their life. It becomes something that they retreat to for all of their problems. And it pulls them away from God. So when we visit the schools, I get a chance to talk to thousands of kids at one time. It's emotional when I go down there, in that there's moments where I feel the conviction of selfishness, of not being thankful for what I have. When I see people around me, when I see children, when I see families that are struggling, but I see them with a heart for Christ, it makes me look at my own life and wonder where my heart is. When Christ works in our hearts, He's pulling out each one of us. He's pushing each one of us to go in different directions, to do certain things. But we have so many things that can get in the way, with so many things that block us from that. And what I've seen on these trips is just an abandon to that. Just letting everything go and just going all in. I think that my prayers is that we can see that here in this country. That we can see a movement of youth that will just, the stirring in their heart will just push them, will just compel them to go forward towards Christ. If people do not hear about God, how will they know Him? If we don't go out and preach the word, how will they hear it? I thought about that and I wondered why Christ compelled me to do this. And then I finally came to a realization that He compels all of us. I just was able to make the decision to get out of my own way and let Him use me to serve Him. So we do, of course, need financial help. We're always looking for people to support us. If your heart is led to that, financially, prayerfully. Most importantly, I think I'd like people to think about how they can serve. Not necessarily in huge mission trips across the world, but just every day to their neighbors, to children, at the church, to anyone they go by. If we looked at our lives for moment, and we see it as opportunities, every moment, every second, every minute, an opportunity to serve God, we have to ask ourselves what we're doing with it. Have we just let it go by, or are we utilizing those moments to serve Him?